Good morning, dear students. Now we are going to solve remaining problems which are based on curl of a given vector. Okay, so in previous lecture we already solved one problem. Okay, so from that problem you will get ideas, okay, about how to solve the problems. Now we are solving problem number 2, okay, which is show that vector f is equal to cos y into I cap minus x into sin y j cap minus cos z k cap is a conservative field. Okay, so just recall from the definition of conservative field, when field is known as conservative, if curl of a given vector field is zero. Okay, so for problem number 2, for conservative field, for conservative force field, curl is 0. Okay, so we have to find out first curl of a given force. If this curl will become 0, then automatically we know that such force field is conservative. So from definition of curl, I cap, J cap, K cap, okay, so here we have dab by dab x, which are coefficients of del and coefficients of f are cos y, okay, then minus x into sin y, okay, minus cos z, okay. Now we have to solve this determinant. So this is equal to I cap multiply by, so I cap multiply by partial derivative of cos z with respect to y is 0, okay, and partial derivative of x sin y with respect to z is also 0. So 0 minus 0 minus j cap into partial derivative with respect to z of cos y is 0 minus partial derivative of x with respect to cos z is also 0 plus k cap into, okay, partial derivative with respect to x of this term is minus sin y, okay, minus partial derivative with respect to y of cos y. So that is again minus sin y, okay. So this is equal to, this will become 0, this will become 0, and here minus sin y minus minus plus sin y. So this term will also become 0. So we will get 0 vector on the right hand side. Okay, then automatically if curl of this force is 0, then such force field represents conservative force field. Okay, so with this we finish problem number 2. Okay, now we are going to solve problem number 3. What is problem number 3? That I written on the top over here. Solution of problem number 3. So problem number 3, show that curl of linear velocity of any particle of rotating body is 2 times its angular velocity. Okay, that we have to prove. So for that, linear velocity v can be written as in terms of angular velocity, okay, v is equal to r cross omega. Okay, now here first we have to find out component, and afterwards we have to take curl of linear velocity. We have to take curl of linear velocity, and that becomes 2 times its angular velocity. Okay, that we have to prove. Okay, here. So to prove this, first of all, we must find out this. Okay, and afterwards we will find curl. Okay, so let vector r, we know that vector r is x I cap, y j cap, and z k cap. Okay, and if omega having components omega x I cap, omega y sorry, j cap, and omega z k cap, then vector v is equal to, okay, to find out vector v component in terms of omega and r, I cap, j cap, k cap, okay, then first of all, component of omega r, omega x, omega y and omega z, okay, and component of r are x, y and z, so this is equal to I cap into, okay, so I cap into, here we get z into omega y minus y into omega z minus j cap into, minus j cap into, what are those component by solving this determinant, z into omega x minus x into omega z plus k cap into, okay, y into omega x minus x into omega y. So here this is x component which is vx, this is y component which is vy, and this is z component which is vz of linear velocity in terms of omega and r. Now we have to take curl of this vector v, okay, so by taking curl here, I will rub this out, by taking curl, let del cross v, which is curl of this linear velocity, is equal to, again we know that this is determinant I cap, j cap, okay, and k cap, so del dabba by dabba x, dabba by dabba y and dabba by dabba z. So here vector v in terms of this r and omega components, x component is what, z into omega y minus y into omega z, okay, j component, here if you multiply with this negative sign, this if you take negative sign common, so this term will become first term and this term will become second term, okay, so x omega z minus z omega x, here y into omega x, okay, minus x into omega y, so these are the x, y and z components. Now this is equal to, I cap into, here first of all we have to take derivative with respect to y of this term. If you take derivative with respect to y of this term, okay, so that will become derivative with respect to y of this term, okay, here if you differentiate this term, I am going to solve this determinant, okay, directly, so dabba by dabba y of this term, if you take derivative with respect to y, so that will become omega x, and derivative of this term with respect to y is 0, so omega x minus, we have to take derivative with respect to z of this term, so that will become, this term will become 0 and derivative with respect to z is minus omega x, okay, minus j cap into, now derivative with respect to x of this term, so that is minus omega y minus derivative with respect to z of this term, which is minus omega z, we are taking derivative with respect to z, so that is minus omega y, okay, see omega y, plus k cap into, now here derivative with respect to x of this term, which is omega z, okay, derivative of this term with respect to x will become 0, and now derivative with respect to y of this term, which is minus omega z, now this is equal to, see omega x minus minus omega x, so that will become 2 times omega x, omega y minus omega y. So this will become minus 2 times omega y. With this negative sign, that will become positive 2 times omega y. Here again 2 times omega z. So we can write this as 2 times, okay, omega x I cap, omega y j cap, and omega z k cap. And by definition, this is nothing but omega. So that is 2 times omega. So curl of linear velocity is 2 times its angular velocity in case of rotation. So with this, we finish problem number 3. Okay. Now we are going to solve problem number 4. Show that vector field vector f is equal to z square 2x plus 3y I cap plus 3x 2y z j cap plus y 2zx k cap is irrotational but not solenoidal. Okay. So for that, from definition of irrotational vector field, we know that when field is known as irrotational vector field, if curl of given vector field is zero, such vector field is known as irrotational vector field. So we have to find out curl of vector f and show that its curl is zero, then automatically it will become irrotational and solenoidal. Remember, from the definition of solenoidal vector field, the vector field is solenoidal if its divergence is zero. Okay. Now here, first of all, in problem number 4, we have to find out curl of given vector. So del cross f is equal to determinant. So I am going to put this determinant as it is. Okay. But only x, y, z component of this f will change. So determinant, first row is same. Okay. And second row, first of all, x component, z square plus 2x plus 3y. So z square plus 2x plus 3y. Then y 3x plus 2y plus z, 3x plus 2y plus z, and z y plus 2 times z into x. Okay. Now this is equal to I cap into. So solve this determinant. To solve this determinant, I cap into partial derivative with respect to y of this term. So if you take derivative of this term with respect to y, so we will get 1 minus derivative of this term with respect to z. Here is no z term. Derivative of this term with respect to z is 1 minus j cap into. Okay. So derivative with respect to x of this term, okay, which is 2z, minus derivative with respect to z of this term, which is again 2z. See, here 2x, 3y, their derivative is 0, and z square, so derivative is 2z. Plus k cap into, okay, derivative with respect to x of this term, which is 3, minus derivative with respect to y of this term, which is again 3. So this is equal to, so 1 minus 1 is 0, 2z minus 2z 0, 0. So here we get 0 vector, and from this since hence f is irrotational, okay, by definition of irrotational vector field. Now in the second part, we have to show that this is irrotational but not solenoidal. So to find out solenoidal, we have to take divergence. Okay. So by taking divergence, let del dot f, which is divergence of f, is equal to. So remember, from definition of divergence, how we will find out divergence? This is x component, y component, z component. We will differentiate this x component with respect to x, plus with this with respect to y, and this with respect to z. We already solved problems which are based on divergence. So recalling that, if we differentiate this with respect to x, so that will become 2, plus if we differentiate with respect to 2, y, that will become 2, okay? And plus if we differentiate with respect to z, so that will become 2x. So this will become 4 plus 2x, which is not equal to 0. If this will become 0, then we know that such field is solenoidal, okay? So from this, we finish our problem number 4. Now moving to last problem, which is problem number 5 of curl, okay? So what is problem number 5? Show that vector f is equal to y square plus 2x into z square I cap plus 2xy minus zj cap plus 2x square z minus y plus 2zk cap is irrotational. So remember from the definition of irrotational vector field, if vector field whose curl is 0, such vector field is irrotational vector field. So for that we have to find out curl, okay? So del cross f is equal to, again I am going to keep this determinant as it is because first row is same, okay, I cap, j cap, k cap. In the second row, what we will get? In the second row, we have to take coefficient, x coefficient, which is y square plus 2x into z square. So y square plus 2x into z square, then coefficient, y coefficient, 2xy minus z, and z coefficient 2x square z minus y plus 2 into z. Now this is equal to, we have to solve this determinant. Okay, so I cap into, see, differentiating this term with respect to y. If we differentiate this term with respect to y, so here we will get minus 1 and minus. We have to differentiate this term with respect to z. So if we differentiate with respect to z, we will get minus 1 minus j cap into, okay, differentiate with respect to x to this term. So that will become 4x into z minus, we have to differentiate this term with respect to z, okay? So that will become 4x into z plus k cap into, okay? So here we have to differentiate this term with respect to x. So that will become 2y minus, differentiate this term with respect to y. So that will again become 2y. So this is equal to, so minus 1 here, minus minus 1, which will become plus 1. So 0 into I cap. So minus j cap 4xz minus 4xz. So that will become also 0. Okay. And here 2y minus 2y. So that will also become 0. So on the right hand side, we get 0 vector. So recall from the definition of curl, if curl of given vector field is 0, then we can say, hence vector f is irrotational. Okay, so with this we finish this problem, okay, and also our lecture.